You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Crashing through the lies and disinformation, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Talk about what's really important here today, ladies and gentlemen. At least in the last 30 minutes of the broadcast, in about an hour and a half, we're going to talk about the Dallas Cowboys and the Green Bay Packers game, Dallas losing in the fourth quarter with two touchdowns, because I'm the big sports broadcaster now. We're going to talk conspiracy. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, but everyone I know, I didn't watch the game. Even though I was at a laser tag place with my children, they had it up on big screen television everywhere. The parents were all there ignoring their children and watching the game. So I saw some of it, but I wasn't officially watching it. It is a controversy. Did Dez Bryant get robbed of an amazing catch? Well, I've seen the play replayed over and over again. I'm no NFL ref, but call me a turnip plant if he didn't catch the ball fair and square. And there were some other plays like that. So he called Brian Toohey. He, of course, has been a guest on everything from ESPN to you name it. He wrote, "The fix is in. Professional sports, but also right now to high school sports, has massive betting on it. And fixing games, fixing boxing matches is ubiquitous. There is a massive cultural conspiracy, though, of not wanting to admit it because it's become the center of American life, at least the center of American male life." So we will talk to the author of The Fix Is In. You know what? Let's just get him on at the start of the second hour. I said the last 30 minutes. Let's do the start of the second hour if he can do it. I know we called him on short notice. We called him and I said, "Does this look staged?" Because a lot of stuff we call him on, he says, "No, it doesn't look staged." He said, "Very, very suspicious." And he's gotten into the secretive FBI files, you name it, and gotten documents out nobody else has. So he is the expert on fixing games. That is from a journalist perspective. Obviously, we know who the real expert is. Be somebody like Don King or folks out in Las Vegas. But the naive public, some of the public still doesn't think there's any fixing. That's why when famous baseball players like Rose and others got caught doing it, it was such a big deal. And folks got lifetime bans because the public is supposed to be naive and not know this type of stuff is going on so that they're just blissfully ignorant for the rest of their lives. That is coming up in the second hour because I don't usually get into distractions and diversions like sports, but if I can show people how it's robbing them of their lives, robbing them of their manhood, robbing them of true military thinking that your brain's designed to engage in daily life, in business, in politics, in religion, and that they suck all of those calculative energies into football and fantasy football and baseball and basketball, when you realize that it's designed as a gladiatorial diversion, it's very helpful for a lot of folks. Sports addiction is what I'd call it. Video game addiction. Statistically, these guys that play 10 hours of video games a day are economically in bad shape. They're disconnected from reality. They're not living in the real world. And so really, it's a discussion about the Matrix in the larger sum total. So that's coming up today in the second hour. In the meantime, the really important news, world news. Worldwide terror freakout over the 15 dead in France. Science and tech news. It's all coming up. Oh, guess what? Infowars.com. Dead French terrorist linked to Pentagon dinner guest Anwar al-Awlaki, the leader of al-Qaeda, who secretly hangs out at the Pentagon. That was in the London Guardian, by the way. We're going to go over all this and more. And I saw a demonstration for Charlie Hebdo in Austin. I caught video of it. That's coming up, too.
Every year, we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
We now take you live to the Central Texas Command Center in the heart of the resistance, rallying patriots worldwide. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. It is the 11th day of January 2015. We are broadcasting worldwide live on this Sunday transmission. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We're going to be here for the next 2 hours. We have the author, Brian Toohey, of The Fix Is In, one of the leading experts on fixed sports, and government media really works to cover this up because the amount of gambling on sports is roughly eight times, in the studies he and others have done, eight times the profit that professional sports get from television, advertising, and ticket sales. So sports is about gambling. And it's also about diverting the public and distracting them into what I call a proto-matrix of things that really don't matter. A male soap opera with all the players and the baseball cards and the rest of it. I'm not criticizing people that love sports. It's just that they criticize me when they start asking me about the game and what I think, and I just say, sorry, I don't follow it. They will just shake in disbelief and laugh at me. I'm sorry, I follow business and academia and science and government and geopolitical systems, and that's why, on record, major leaders of governments listen to the show. It's why we're the number one broadcast from every metric out there at the Pentagon. That's why we have so many CIA and NSA and FBI and you name it whistleblowers here on this broadcast, because I live in a real man's world. Not in a fantasy man's world, watching other men slap each other on their butts. And I want to be clear, I played football, I went to Dallas Cowboys games, I grew up in Dallas, Texas. I like football. But what it's been turned into with its Obamacare pushing, its anti-gun garbage, firing the host of Monday Night Football, Hank Williams Jr., because he criticized Obama on Fox News. Oh, but there's Charlie Hebdo demonstrations all over the world. I saw one in Austin today. I was driving around downtown, drove by the city council building, about 400 people demonstrating. I have video of it. One of my tech folks, Buckley Hammond, is in there downloading it right now. We'll have that for TV viewers. We're simulcasting TV at InfoWars.com/show. You can find the free feed. Or go to prisonplanet.tv and subscribe to get it all in HD and see the nightly news and all my films and more. But the point is that we're going to break all that down as well and look at the announcements being made. Our story from InfoWars.com with links to the foreign press making the announcements is top linked at DrudgeReport.com, and we'll go there and click through that for folks. Government prepares internet speech crackdown following Paris attacks. That's the top link there at DrudgeReport.com. We're going to be going over that. So demonstrate and march for free speech
and stand up against the fear of terrorism, which I'm absolutely for, but then censor free speech and continue opening the borders and bringing radicals in at record levels. We're going to decipher this, decode it, break it all down today. And then again, in the second hour, we're going to talk sports betting fraud. We're going to talk, the number one area for fraud is with the refs. You target the refs when you can't get 11 people on each side of the football to basically throw it, when you can't get the quarterback to throw it, when you can't get a key running back to throw it, because the coach will just put somebody else in there if they're not performing. Who do you go after? You go after the refs. And the Cowboys were propelled into the playoffs with obviously fraudulent calls with the Lions, and now they've been taken out by Green Bay with two different plays that a vegetable could watch, a turnip could watch, as I said earlier. A turnip could watch it and see that it was clearly caught. So we're going to be breaking it all down today, ladies and gentlemen, and looking behind the curtain of sports. Looking behind the curtain of what most men see as their identity as a male is watching narcissistic males be worshipped on television while their lives fall apart and while they conquer nothing and their wife tells them what to do all day. Or they sit in the basement in their underwear eating Hot Pockets and Funyuns, scratching their Wavos while their wife bosses them around, or they don't even have a wife. While their kids play Xbox Kinect in the next room, being biometrically scanned and put into a database. While Samsung comes out with their new smart digital TVs and says, third parties are listening and watching you, so watch what you say. That was in the owner's manual that came out 2 months ago. While all these insane things are going on, while we're signed on to $2 quadrillion in foreign fake derivatives debt, that's not our debt. That's 2,000 trillion, ladies and gentlemen. That's the global derivatives, and we're signed on to about half of that. The U.S. is. It's not our debt. It's fraudulent megabanks debt. The public is ignorant about economics. They're ignorant about the banking cartels. They're ignorant about the private run-for-profit Federal Reserve. They're ignorant about the social engineering that's going on. The real game is the fight against the globalist. A game is a simulation generally of warfare or of business, of competition. But what happens when the game becomes the whole world and that's all people care about, and then your life is not successful, you're not fulfilled because you've put your whole identity into a game or into the color of your skin? Oh, I've got to support Obamacare. Obama's black. I don't want to be called racist. Or, oh, I better support it. I'm black and Obama's black. Or I better turn my guns in. I'll be called racist. I better speak the way the media says, or I'll be called politically incorrect. Who cares what a bunch of social engineers tell us to do? Reject their culture. That's what I'm going to get into in the second hour. Now, that said, last week I told the crew, don't really dig it up because I say it so much. What's the point of doing it? But I even Google searched, Alex Jones says ISIS will attack the West, or Alex Jones says Al-Qaeda in Syria, well, what it was previously called till a year ago, will attack the West. And all the videos come up from the radio show, the Nightly News. It's all there. We're going to get some of those clips tomorrow so that for new listeners, we can show you that we predicted all this. So let's get one thing straight first. Radical Islamic terror is real and does take place and does happen. And from all the MO I've looked at, it looks like these three attackers in France were real terrorists and that what happened basically happened. Now let's remove that out of the equation. I'm going to come back and break this down with all the latest news. It was the White House Chief of Staff, now the mayor of Chicago, the Don, Emanuel, Rahm Emanuel, his brother helped write Obamacare that has the death panels and admits it and laughs at everyone and hey, we're going to bankrupt everything. He says that on Fox News, just like Gruber laughing at us, but that's another side issue. He said, you don't let a good crisis go to waste. And they are undoubtedly now going to use the 15 dead or whatever it is. The numbers keep changing. 12 dead, including two police officers the first day. Hostages killed when they killed him on Friday. Whatever. That's all just minutia of the sad event. Our hearts go out to those that died. But this will be used to legitimize the surveillance state, the police state, the basic loss of liberties all over the world that the global financial class that's anti-free market is promoting and pushing, and it will be used on the general public. It will not be used on radical Islam. And so when we come back, I will document that the West has been funding Al-Qaeda. I predict it would blow back. It now has. And the very leaders involved funding the terrorists, Sarkozy and others, are on television, Hollande, all of them, marching as if they're saviors now when they have blood on their hands. We're going to break it all down.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet colloidal silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
So CNN has the big headline on their website, "Where was Obama?" And now it's, oh, there was no major U.S. envoy, not even Secretary of State, at this big march with Hollande and Sarkozy and Benjamin Netanyahu and all these other European leaders, Angela Merkel of Deutschland, the chancellor. I love how the media manipulates the sentimentality of the West, especially. Look at these headlines. U.S. terror official on terror attacks. This isn't going to stop. Quote, it's going to be like the war on drugs. It will never end. Yeah, we're criminal elements of the government and major corporations, big banks, Wells Fargo and Wachovia on record, chartering the aircraft, $378 billion in narcotics money from 2007 to 2009, Bloomberg reported. In 2009, didn't even get in trouble. Paid $111 million fine on 300 and something billion. They owned the aircraft. It always has to do with terror. The war on drugs. They ship the drugs in, destabilize things, create a giant underclass, and then fill the private prisons owned by the drug dealers with the morons that use the illegal drugs. Same thing with terror. You create the terrorist, protect them, shepherd them. They attack. You go kill them. People say, what do you mean? They worked for the government? The two brothers and their friend and their dumb bimbo girlfriend? No. The armaments, the training, the safe areas are given to them by NATO in Syria, in areas of Iraq, as the Free Syrian Army. Then they train other Western jihadis that have been traveling there. From France, the U.S., England, you name it. They then come back into France, work with networks that give them fully auto weapons and grenade launchers, and then they go and kill people. That's a fact. Look at this headline. U.S. official on terror attacks. This isn't going to stop. CNN. Source. Terror cells activated in France. More attacks coming. Oh, my gosh. Militarize the police right now. Dianne Feinstein. Terror sleeper cells are in the U.S., but she wants totally open borders. See? White House to hold global security summit February 18th. U.S. officials to prepare, Reuters says, for the new global jihad they're facing. They say a new jihad. In fact, in the CNN article quoting the U.S. officials, they say, the disease has metastasized. The cancer is spreading. It's going to be much bigger than 9/11. Funny, I have a bunch of clips from April 22nd, September 26th, and January 16th where I say all that. In fact, this is just what the crew was able to find. There are tapes out there where I say shoot up newspapers, schools, and shopping malls because that's what terrorists target. Obama has family leading the Muslim takeover of Kenya who on record are directly connected to the Al-Qaeda cells that shot up the shopping mall. I mean, that's in the Kenyan newspapers. That's in the Egyptian newspapers. I had Ahmad Salim, the famous colonel on, the Egyptian colonel who worked with the FBI, to try to stop the World Trade Center attack in 93. They told him to stand down. I had him on breaking all this down Thursday. Of course, I already know all this, but the point is that this is going on. So let me, it's a complex issue. It's also very, very simple. There are criminal interests in government and major corporations at the top that want to convert us to a tyranny so they can steal our pension funds, raise our taxes, and sign us on to fiat derivatives. To do that, they need to have an outside threat. So they go and they fund radical Al-Qaeda groups. It'd be just like if I bred rattlesnakes in my basement and went and put them in my neighbor's, closet. So when they walk in the closet, a rattlesnake will bite them. The rattlesnake doesn't work for me. It's a rattlesnake. Just like if I breed 100 black widows and dump them in your bed when you're at work and you come home at night, the black widows will go under the bed. They'll get up in the sheets. When you roll over on one, it's going to bite you. Now, do I mind control? Do I run the black widow? No, I dumped them in your bed. Now, I'm driving downtown today, visiting some friends about 2 hours ago, and I see about 300, 400 people marching with, in French, I am Charlie Hebdo, the satirical newspaper that got attacked last week. And it was a nice crowd, families out there, and they look so proud of themselves out demonstrating. The mainstream media is promoting it. This is a good, safe demonstration. They're in front of the city council, and then they march down Cesar Chavez, First Street, towards Colorado, and then to Congress and the Capitol. And they were very proud of themselves. I shot video of it. We took it off my iPhone. We'll be playing it later, if you're a TV viewer. And they look so proud. And a lot of them were French citizens. They had French flags, French shirts, a big French community in Austin. There's a little problem with that. They should have been wearing black in mourning and apologizing because France led, and has been given praise by our evil media for this, the Free Syrian Army with NATO, and gave them most of the weapons along with England, and Israel gives them support out of Lebanon in the Golan Heights bordering Syria. That's in Jerusalem Post. Headline, Benjamin Netanyahu. Why we need Al-Qaeda, headline. The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Bull. Assad didn't attack Israel, didn't attack the U.S. Women could go to college. They were democratizing the country. They used the opening up of the country to infiltrate it with jihadis that have killed over 300,000 people in the last 4 years. Our own military went public and said, we don't want to be Al-Qaeda's Air Force. Remember 2 years ago when Obama wanted to invade? Think of the hypocrisy and the over-the-top bizarreness that NATO countries led by France, who usually tries to stay out of wars, but this one was so evil, I guess France had to get involved. I'm not demonizing France. I just don't understand why they got involved so heavily when they usually get criticized for not being in every war, something I think that's positive. Because they want the pipelines that are going to go through there. And they want to cut off the Russian pipeline, the Russian port. It's about hundreds of billions of dollars or euros. So, here are the French upset that they've lost 15 citizens. I think it's terrible 15 people are killed. What about the 350 plus thousand Christians, Jews, and mainly Muslim non-radical minority Alawites? They go into major cities and they round up every man, woman, and child. And they sell the little 10-year-old girls off to sex slavery. They sexually mutilate the other ones. They burn up churches, crucify. The Muslim Brotherhood is the same group. They did this in Egypt, and our media, CNN, backed it and called them freedom fighters. Does anyone remember this? Now, when we come back, I'm going to play you. They found some of the clips where I said they're going to attack us. In fact, here's Kurt Nemo's article from March 26th of this year, or now last year. 10 months ago, CIA, Al-Qaeda, using Syria as a base of operations to attack the West. U.S. specializes in creating terror threat, then used to steal our liberty. And Kurt Nemo in here has my videos predicting it in March of what was going to happen, and now it's happened. Stay with us.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I could see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know the fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet colloidal silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. InfoWarsLife.com. Check it out today. I have set out to bring you the most hardcore, cutting-edge supplements and nutraceuticals, bar none, and that's what you'll find at InfoWarsLife.com. We have rejected literally hundreds of products from the InfoWars Life line because they are not of the very highest quality, or because they're not 100% organic, or because they don't pass all of the strictest toxicology tests there are that we have listed at InfoWarsLife.com. Whether it's Survival Shield Nascent Iodine or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com and believed in us and tried the products. Folks, check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. From the front lines of the information war, it's Alex Jones.
In the last 2 years, I've made a giant deal out of this because folks should listen up carefully. What's now happening is going to be used to fundamentally strip the general public of your rights and your money and your freedom to travel. This is a public plan to convert us to a tyranny. RAND Corporation is on record. Now, before I play these audio clips where I predicted this, I want to give you articles that are even more precise. This article is by Paul Watson and Alex Jones,
March 21st, 2013. I'm going to have it reposted to the front page of Infowars.com by Kit Daniels in the next 10 minutes. Obama now global head of Al-Qaeda. Will president order drone strikes on White House was the question sarcastically, because our government is one of the main funders along with France. France is maybe a close second, number one in Europe. Everybody's involved, though. Turkey, Italy, Germany, England, Israel. And the article breaks down in three pages with links to how our government is funding Al-Qaeda, who they then changed the name of to ISIS. Here's the headline. These same terrorists who've also vowed to attack the United States once they're finished in Syria, while proclaiming their desire to see Al-Qaeda flag flying over the White House. In addition, while Americans who are suspicious of centralized federal authority and reverent of the individual liberty have been characterized as terrorists by their own government, U.S. citizens who openly take up arms to join the terrorists in Libya and Syria are allowed to fly around the world with total impunity. And we have links to mainstream news from the U.S. and England where they let jihadis, sometimes whole plane loads, get on commercial flights to go land in Jordan and Turkey, saying they're with Al-Qaeda and ISIS, same group. Just means Islamic State of Al-Qaeda. So people ask, how'd they get RPGs? How'd they go train in Yemen? The three attackers in Paris that left 20 dead, said 15 earlier, it's 20 now. They've revised the numbers and upped them. They were trained by this coalition of Saudi Arabia, Yemen, and others that are funding jihadis to take over the Middle East and take out moderate regimes. And the blissfully ignorant Americans and French and others go out and protest against radical Islam threatening free speech, which I think is very positive and I totally support. One day before, Angela Merkel was talking about banning anti-radical Islam demonstrations across Germany, but she decided she couldn't ban it, so she backed off. Today, we can show you the front page of CNN's website, she marched with the French president and other world leaders for free speech. I mean, this is sick. Do you see where I'm coming from? And then there's this backdrop. We vomit on all these people who suddenly say they are our friends, says Charlie Hebdo cartoonist who survived as he scoffs at surge in support. It is just a lot of people who you'd never see demonstrate any other time. They're doing it now because the media is saying it's safe and cool. Why don't the French, why don't Austinites go out and demonstrate against our government for 4 years, giving over $10 billion to Al-Qaeda in Iraq and Syria that now became ISIS and has blown back on our military in Iraq and is killing them? Why don't we have a march apologizing for overthrowing the Egyptian government and putting these people in charge there that Anderson Cooper and others endorsed? Remember that? Until there was a counter coup by the military, thank God, to stop the Muslim Brotherhood that was burning down every church in the country. Every church was blown up, basically. And the Christians were crucified at the government building. They kick our allies out and do that. This is part of a global destabilization program, and they're going to attack us. And I said, it's going to start with churches, media institutions, shopping malls, and primary schools being attacked. That's the type of thing that real terrorists hit, just like terrorists connected to Obama. I can't believe I'm saying this. It's true. The Kenyan attacks, look it up, are directly connected to his cousins and to Odinga, the leader of the Muslim movement. That's like their radical arm, kind of like Sinn Féin's the nice arm of the Irish Republican Army. Well, they have their military arm. And Obama is directly in control of the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt that he's gone and addressed, ladies and gentlemen. This is bizarre. You can draw what inferences you want out of this, but this is confirmed. Do you understand, if you're a new listener, they're now saying your way of life is over on CNN. Al-Qaeda is about to start hitting us. They've reconstituted in Syria and Iraq. And no one at CNN, no one on MSNBC, no one at Fox, no one anywhere. I've read all these articles that are transcripts of the shows, the news programs. No one says, gee, Ron Paul or Rand Paul was right, or Ted Cruz was right. We shouldn't have armed the Syrian, Free Syrian Army, because 90% of them are Al-Qaeda. I mean, they blow up outdoor markets, they blow up mosques, they blow up the churches. They go through towns and kill whole families, thousands of people a day in some cases, for 4 years. Our government is giving Stinger missiles to these people. And I'm telling you, they will end up using them. They'll end up smuggling them like they did the RPGs into Paris, and they'll end up using them on us. And when airliners get shot down, it'll be real. The government won't have to go out and provocateur anybody, because they already created a vacuum to put 200,000 of these jihadis in and let them fly back and forth all over the world. I get searched almost every time I fly. I'm on a list. Little government harassment. No criminal record other than speeding tickets. Hadn't had one of those in like 6-7 years. That's not true. I got one about 3 years ago. Congressmen get harassed. Ron Paul gets harassed. But boy, you're a jihadi with a Facebook saying you're going to kill people like one of these brothers did. He had that thing up for 4 years. He'd been in prison. He followed a radical imam that called for violence. And he was allowed to fly to Yemen and post videos of himself and photos at terrorist training camps. It's in the news. And the answer is NSA surveillance, total surveillance, and internet censorship of all of us, because the $300 billion intelligence budget of the United States, the multi-hundred billion euro program of the EU every year, can't go arrest somebody when they're on their Facebook saying, I've been to Yemen and I'm going to start killing people. And now we learn they've been warned by the Yemenese government. Now we learn the French government knew. Of course they did. Just like Hassan at Fort Hood, for 2 years, he was in contact with Anwar al-Awlaki, planning that attack, that crazy psychiatrist, a lone wolf. Anwar al-Awlaki in the London Guardian and Associated Press was caught meeting secretly at the Pentagon more than 14 times. Here's another. See who's leading this? Dead French terrorist linked to Pentagon dinner, guest Anwar al-Awlaki. The French brothers announced connection prior to death following the Charlie Hebdo attack. Kurt Nemo, that was Saturday's article, Infowars.com. You understand? Here are articles. Obama now head of Al-Qaeda. March. CIA, Al-Qaeda using Syria as base of operations to attack West when the CIA put them in. And then I've got people say, aren't you going to go march for free speech for the Charlie Hebdo? You know, I'm not going to make those people mad. Maybe I should have marched with them and gone up and asked them, hey, are you mad that France and the U.S. and others funded this very group and then let them fly back and forth? Oh, don't get in the middle of me feeling good about how I'm demonstrating for free speech right now. Okay, well, they're going to use this to take free speech. And France is one of the most censored places in the world now under the EU political correctness. Shut up. I'm here to feel like I have free speech. See, you only have free speech when the system wants you to have it, if they have their way. All these Democrats now calling for free speech, they're the ones who want the fairness doctrine where this show could not air. So when we come back, I've got the clips of where we predict these attacks taking place 6 months ago, 9 months ago, you name it. Just to show you again, it's not rocket science. Our government turns over large areas of the Middle East, oil fields, and weapons to a bunch of crazy jihadis, lets them recruit in every Western country so they can then export these little terrorists back here, and then the government can come in and sweep them up and be the savior while taking our freedoms.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com.
Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality silver bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your silver bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Several months back, I started taking your Nason Iodine and your Super Meal. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Your products are great. I use DNA Force. I use X2.
Thank
Super
you.
Male Vitality and Lung Cleanse. Every day, they're great stuff.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nason Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shields, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's true. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox in the body. It's great stuff.
Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products. Cells become toxic, they die early, and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA Force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
You are a programmable guy that goes and watches Olympus is Falling and believes all this and really thinks you're a hero. G.I. Joe, great American hero. Yo, Joe. You don't work for Joe. Joe got taken over. The G.I. Joe command base is run by Cobra. Do you understand that? And I use a child analogy to get through to you because that's your main programming template in North America. They're on record with that. That was all Pentagon directed. You understand? You work for Cobra. You dress like Cobra. You have the tactics of Cobra. You are Cobra. Hail Cobra. You want to be little boys? Or do you want to really join the Republic?
They know what's going on at the Bundy Ranch, and they won't even let a police information officer give us any information. That's a bunch of bull.
It's all these stupid G.I. Joe movies and stuff where the White House is attacked. The White House is run by Cobra.
When I went through the process of becoming press secretary, one of the first things they told me was, you're not even to acknowledge the drone program. You're not even to discuss that it exists.
It's run by chaos. It's run by Spectre.
Special Executive for Counterintelligence, Terrorism, Revenge, Extortion.
run little kids. They run the snuff films. They run the drugs. They run it all. And because you act like a bunch of naive chumps, this whole thing's going to come down on us.
Very much concerns me, considering that they have all this bulk ammunition that they're shooting targets of children.
Would you like to tell me who it is that is doing this?
It is the Department of Homeland Security, sir.
Oh, thank you for calling.
To every police officer in this country, to every FBI agent, to every Secret Service agent, you work for Spectre. You work for Chaos. You work for Cobra. How do they get power? They stage a terror attack using Spectre, using Cobra.
Go f*** yourself.
Who is Cobra? Arms dealing, drug dealing, money laundering group wearing masks? They wear masks, ladies and gentlemen, because they're the corporate CEOs. And they're manipulating the governments against each other. Cobra runs the Muslims. Cobra runs the CIA. Cobra runs it all. Cobra is real. You can call it whatever you want. Cobra is in control of America. And Cobra says the veterans and the gun owners, they're saying that we're the bad guys.
These people who hold themselves out to be patriots are not. They're nothing more than domestic terrorists.
That's what Cobra would say. That's what Spectre would say. That's what Goldfinger would say, because that's who those people are.
I am Supreme Cobra Commander. You call your petty bureaucrats, officials, and authorities, you will kneel before Cobra or face my wrath.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Thank you for joining us, Mr. Cobra Leader.
You pathetic little worm. How dare you call me Mr. Cobra?
That's a promo Jakari Jackson put out about 10 months ago during the Bundy Ranch standoff, where I was pointing out that major global crime syndicates, the large six banks that own the private Federal Reserve and the EU banks, even the Rolling Stone had the headline 2 years ago, the fix is in, everything's rigged, and listed the six banks that I'd listed in films 15 years ago, 7 years ago, and two different films. I mean, I really know what I'm talking about. And if they want to take our freedom, how do they do it? They fund terror groups. And they put out a worldwide call for young jihadis. You know, you're a young radical Muslim. You don't want to go join the army to prove you're a man or the Marines. You go join the jihad. And they even let them. Even CNN reported. We have links in our articles about this when we warned of this months ago. They let them fly there and let them get trained, including the three guys that are dead that killed 20 people. That's why I wanted to come on here and be calm about this today, but we shouldn't be calm. This is outrageous. And now our story is linked up on drudgereport.com. Government prepares internet speech crackdown following Paris attacks. I'm going to get into the agenda of how this will be used, what this will push when we start the next hour. Then we're going to look at the Super Bowl coming up and a lot of these really obvious plays that even on the playback, they're not overriding the refs and clearly fraudulent calls. Two of those calls cost the Cowboys this event. By the way, I'm not a Cowboys fan. I was overdosed on it as a child. I just can't stand it. The arrogance of the team, the whole nine yards, I can't stand it. So when I say that it looked like the Cowboys had the stolen from them, that's from somebody just looking at it. I like Green Bay because they're owned by the fans, but I don't like football itself because it's an Obama promoting, open borders promoting, carbon tax promoting, anti-gun promoting, censorship thing that'll fire anybody that works for the NFL if they criticize socialism like Hank Williams Jr. And it's used as a giant distraction. We'll talk about that in the next hour. But we're going to look at sports betting and a lot and who they target. They target the refs, folks. And if you don't know that refs throughout professional sports and even college are getting paid off in some cases to throw games, you are naive. I mean, because it's documented. And that's coming up with the expert who wrote the book on it, The Fix Is In, with Brian Toomey. Brian Toomey. This is teleprompter-free radio and TV. We have a free video feed at Infowars.com/show. Please don't ever forget, this is a very important transmission. And we gain affiliates, we lose affiliates. Stations change format, stations sell. We're on over 100 affiliates on the Sunday broadcast, over 170 on the weekday transmission. But affiliates come and go. We appreciate all of our affiliates, but spread the word about the broadcast. If you're listening on AM or FM, or spread the word about the free podcast, the free iPhone app, the Droid apps, all in the listen page of Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, and tell your friends and family about the broadcast. Be the Paul Revere's of the 21st century. Because this show and my news team and all of it is only one part of the equation. I'm kind of like the coach that tries to motivate people at a pep rally to wake up and take action. But our articles, our videos, our films, our reporters, a lot of it is just downright Pulitzer Prize level. And we've won a lot of awards for it as well. I've won the Free Speech Award, you name it. The point is that it's very valuable, it's growing, and we need your support and prayers now more than ever. Visit InfoWarsStore.com, the high-quality water filters, the high-quality nutraceuticals, the Made in America, pro-gun, Patriot apparel. All of your purchases make this broadcast possible. And your PrisonPlanet.tv memberships to see the nightly news. 20 people can use each membership, $5.95 a month, or get it for a year, and it comes down to $2.50 a month. That's 12 cents a person who uses it, because one membership's 20 memberships, PrisonPlanet.tv. Now, let's end this hour with a few of the predictions. This is just what we can pull up. I just gave you articles and reposted them to the front page of the websites, Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, where I specifically predicted what was going to happen, arming 200,000 jihadis, most of them that live in the U.S. or Europe. They're coming home. They're going to be allowed to come home. They're going to kill a bunch of us. And then we're going to live in a police state. Real simple takeover plan, huh? We have a criminal government with open borders, you name it. Let's go to a seven-second clip, August 22nd, from the radio show. Here it is. They're going to let ISIS take over the Middle East. They're going to attack Europe and attack the United States and shoot down airplanes with the heat-seeking missiles they've been given. Okay, let's go to another 50-second clip from September 26th. Here it is. And the next move, it could be a nuke. They've put a lot of pre-programming out on that. That's after I said mass shooting. City, a huge dirty bomb. But they really want to go after guns. So they'll probably target a Democratic-controlled area where they know they've got a lot of tied-up victims with nobody there to protect them. New York, Chicago, D.C. And they'll go in and just kill it. It could be 200 kids. And then they'll spin it. We need gun control. See, these local ISIS sympathizers got their guns legally at gun shows. I mean, just think about the enemy's mind. Learn how they operate, and what would you do if they were them? That's how I continue to predict what they're going to pull. And you have to understand, there's 3 to 5 hours of broadcast today, because sometimes I do 2 extra hours, an hour extra. The nightly news sometimes goes 5 hours, 10 hours. So there's thousands of hours we're going through, but you all heard me ad nauseum. I predicted they'd attack France a lot. In fact, I know I predicted they would hit them first to get them in line for going along with everything, but France itself has been giving the arms and the money at the leading the pack to take over Syria. So, bottom line, bare minimum, our government's funded these groups and then let them attack us. And then if you're an army soldier having to die in Iraq fighting them, too bad. Or you're a cop getting shot in the head by them, too bad. See, we all lose as free humans to the tyranny. But I do agree with people demonstrating, saying they're not afraid and protesting for free speech. That's good. But do it all the time. Because world leaders have announced they're going to use these attacks to censor the web. You see how that works? So you better demonstrate for that, too, not just when it's politically correct. Second hour coming up. Stay with us.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Was the playoff game between the Packers and the Cowboys fixed? I don't know. Does a duck quack? We got an expert coming on about that. Just to discredit the whole stinking mess. This video just went live. Americans March for Charlie Hebdo Dead. It's on InfoWars.com. If you're a radio listener, but for TV viewers, here is the footage and my commentary driving to the office today, and then some commentary I made right before we went live. We cut the two videos together.
So even in Austin, Texas, they are marching for free speech and against the fear of terrorism for free speech. But France is leading the EU in restricting free speech across the board on other issues. And France was one of the main backers in funding the Islamic Jihad, ISIS, Al-Qaeda in Syria as part of the Free Syrian Army, the main contingent of it, and killed over 300,000 innocent Syrians the last 4 years. But now we've got 13-14 people dead over in France, and it is the cause. Celeb, the mainstream media, is all over it. This is the time to go out. This is the time to do it. This is the time that people are supposed to demonstrate because the media says so. And I think these people mean well. It's just that they need to know the rest of the story. I wish they'd march because they're saying we're all Charlie. We're all Charlie Hebdo, the publication. I wish they would march. I mean, it'd really be fantastic if they do it against our Western governments, NATO and others, funding Al-Qaeda. They just had this in front of the city councils. There's some of the final people here in downtown Austin finishing up the demonstration. And it's just very, very sad that they don't know the rest of the story. EU-wide free speech is being annihilated. Freedoms are being taken away across the board. And it's the very EU that's opened the borders up to dissolve the cultures that are in Europe. And of course, now there's all these reports we must stop Le Pen from controlling the borders of France and not letting unlimited foreigners come in. And the day before the shootings last week, there were demonstrations in France and Germany against the radical Islamification of Europe. And those were decried, though, you see. So it's all limited demonstration that's in a politically correct context. And everybody comes out and demonstrates when it is politically correct to do so. And again, overall support demonstrating for free speech, but this is basically controlled opposition, and they don't even know it. Now, I shot the footage you just saw about an hour ago, driving up to the radio TV studio to do my Sunday broadcast. And once I watched the video, I had two other points I wanted to make. I want to be clear. Most of the people out demonstrating, more power to you. It's your free speech right. I support the power of the pen. It is greater than the sword, as has been said many times.
But even the surviving top cartoonist in the Daily Mail said, we vomit on all these people who suddenly say they are our friends who were criticizing them before or just jumping on the bandwagon. And DrudgeReport.com is top link to our story from Infowars.com. Government prepares internet speech crackdown following Paris attacks. So they're going to use this for internet censorship, for internet surveillance, and to promote NSA-style programs worldwide. So there you go. Daily Mail, Infowars.com. Go check it out for yourself. We shouldn't just go out and demonstrate when they tell us to or when the media says now is the time. The French government and NATO, on record for 4 years, have been arming the ISIS and Al-Qaeda militants that trained these people. Think about that. We should be protesting and mourning our guilt as the West, radicalizing Islamists to take over countries and destabilize them. And then it blows back and the politicians march in solidarity. Benjamin Netanyahu and Hollande and all the rest of them. When Israel is on record funding the Syrian Free Army, that 90% of it's Al-Qaeda. And I'm not an Israel basher, but my God, the hypocrisy of this. I am against funding Al-Qaeda. The ADL will probably say I'm anti-Semitic, so fine, go ahead. I don't support Al-Qaeda. Makes me sick. Infowars.com.
All right, folks, we're going to go to break. I'll tell you who really is doing the right thing. Remember back in 2013, military revolt against Obama's attack on Syria, where thousands of officers held up the sign saying, I will not fight for Al-Qaeda in Syria? That's smart protesting. I told you, it's the military that's awake. They know what's going on.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know the fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
KMLN, Los Angeles, Clone Radio. We play the songs that sound more like everyone else than anyone else. Clone.
Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. The Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns.
I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
There's a red linked article on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Alex Jones predicted Western-backed ISIS would attack West, went on to predict terror attack would be used to dismantle what's left of Western freedom. And that is from an article that we put out titled Obama Now Global Head of Al-Qaeda, Paul Watson, Alex Jones, March 21st, 2013. And we show how they're letting the radicals fly back and forth out of Europe, England, the United States, into Yemen, into Saudi Arabia, into Syria, into Jordan, into Turkey to then launch these attacks when they're promising to come back and attack the West. Our government is doing this. And I love the comments. I love the comments on here. It's got listeners saying, duh, everybody knew ISIS and Al-Qaeda was going to attack us once they were done in Syria. Duh, I know you're my listeners and the readers of Infowars.com.
But the whole audience, you know, is not on the website. In fact, a fraction of it is. We're on over 100 radio stations on the Sunday broadcast. The weekdays, almost double that. Most of our audience is transitory, only listens every once in a while or tunes through. And that's who I really want to reach out to. Don't you remember Ted Cruz, the senator, and Rand Paul, the senator, and all that media the last couple of years saying we shouldn't arm Al-Qaeda? So they changed the name to ISIS to confuse the public. And now they're attacking our troops in Iraq. They're attacking our allies in the Middle East. And they're sending them to come back and kill us. You don't think the West, France, NATO, all these countries that armed Al-Qaeda, it's Al-Qaeda armies with Al-Qaeda flags to go into Syria. More of a secular government, nice compared to Al-Qaeda, to overthrow it. It is a crime the West has committed. But now the world leaders, many of them accomplices, can march in Paris and feel good about themselves and claim it's for free speech. Simply mind-boggling. And it goes on and on and on. In the article, commenter JNDO says, we all predicted ISIS would attack the West. That was the obvious plan from the beginning. Duh. I know. Duh. Are you warning people? Because they're going to take all our freedoms with this, and more attacks are coming. And by the way, I told you that it would probably start in somewhere like France and then roll into Democrat-controlled areas where they know the victims won't fight back. Because they don't want that story of people fighting back. They want the story of whole cities like Boston taking over, looking for one patsy. And the Boston bombing was a staged event. This is how you really protest this. Military revolt against Obama's attack on Syria. Both top brass and regular service members express opposition to U.S. government involvement. That was 2013 in September, a year and a half ago, roughly. And you scroll through it, thousands of tweets of even high-level officers. We're talking majors, colonels, brigadier colonels, or full colonels, lieutenant colonels, you name it. Coming out and saying, I didn't join the military to fight for Al-Qaeda, Infowars.com. Yeah, they also had Infowars.com on it. You think the system liked that? So they changed the name to ISIS to confuse the public. It didn't confuse the military. And then I have these headlines, CNN, U.S. official on terror attacks. This isn't going to stop. It'll be like the war on drugs forever. It has metastasized out of Syria. Who planted the cancer in Syria? I thought Al-Qaeda was beaten. And then suddenly it's all back under a new name. It's metastasized. Dianne Feinstein, terror sleeper cells are in the U.S., brace for attack. But no one, Obama to have an emergency summit to brace for the attacks. Source, terror cells activated in France, more coming. Oh, thank goodness there's army tanks on the sidewalk, and thank goodness there's armored vehicles, and thank goodness they're listening to all of us. The brothers were on Facebook bragging how they were going to kill everybody. We get censored on Facebook, boys and girls, and on Twitter. Memes we put out that are viral, that are just pro-Second Amendment or pro-free speech. But ISIS and Al-Qaeda are allowed to recruit and operate. Because the bigger they get, the more power our government gets to then fight them. Real simple. Remember, there was a famous case in New York 20-something years ago that for a decade, somebody would go around knocking with a ball-peen hammer hundreds of windshields out of night. Turned out it was the guy who had billboards up above it. One detective finally thought, funny how there's all these billboards everywhere, and one guy's getting all the business and opening shops everywhere. They went and investigated. They caught him and a bunch of his workers out with ball-peen hammers at night, smashing windows of cars. It's a famous case. You can look it up. So see, that's what's going on here. But real citizens will die, real cops will die, real military will die. But the big military-industrial complex and the big banks, they'll get to make all the money in the world. The fix is in. Now, the media always strawmans this and says, Alex Jones doesn't think Islamic extremism exists. That's not what I said. And they know it. I said Western governments and corporations are protecting it and shepherding it so they can build the threat to then take our freedoms when they strike. That's what I said. Just like if somebody puts a baby in the pen with five starving pit bulls. I didn't say the man ate the baby. I said he put the baby in a pen with pit bulls to let the pit bulls eat the baby. And it's the same thing. It's premeditated murder. So put that in your pipe and smoke it. Now, shifting gears. The fix is in on a lot of stuff. I told people interest rates were rigged worldwide. It was declassified 2 years ago, the LIBOR scandal. and many other cases of that. Well, I don't watch Don King boxing matches because it's been known for a long time. When I was a teenager, I liked boxing. My dad liked boxing. My grandfather liked boxing. My other grandfather was a boxer. I grew up liking boxing. But everybody quit watching it because everybody knew it was staged. And it got a little too fake. They don't want the NFL and basketball and the rest of it where there's so much rigging. Here's the thing. 8 to 10 times the money gets made in gambling. That gets made in tickets and advertising and merchandise. Okay? That's a fact. Brian Toohey has some of the newer numbers. He's got two books out on it, and he's done a lot of analysis, you name it, from everything from ESPN to... The fix is in. Brandon makes a compelling fact-based argument that not everything in the sports world is as it seems, that behind the visceral thrills and feel-good hype lies the potential dark underworld of profit motives, conflicting interest, and possibly rigged competitions in which nothing occurs by happy accident. Patrick Herbie, ESPN. Whether it's NASCAR, MLB, NBA, NFL, NHL, you name it, the fix is in. Not in everything, but it's there. We're going to go to break, come back, give him the floor for a couple segments, and then open the phones up specifically on the game. The Packers versus the Cowboys today. Of course, the Cowboys lost when the Packers came from behind in the fourth quarter. And two calls that everybody's saying are complete fraud is what basically led the Packers' victory. But wasn't it a bad play that got the Cowboys to be able to say they beat the Lions? And again, just to show you, I don't follow sports. I just know how to read the numbers. But I did see the plays, and it's just a good way to get people thinking and understanding why so much of this happens. If you've got, say, $5, $10 billion being bet just on the playoffs, you think there might be some rigging going on by the Mafia? Oh, no. Oh, no. The Mafia just runs snuff films and child kidnapping rings, different Mafias that are out there. We think of Mafia, it's a stereotype of Italian. That's a very small part of it. You got all these foreign mafias, Russian mafias, Israeli mafias, banking cartel mafias, Latin American mafias, Mexican mob mafias. Interpol's a giant mafia. NATO's the biggest narcotics trafficking mafia in Europe. But we've got all the numbers for you. We're going to talk NFL straight ahead and talk about those plays and break them down with the author of The Fix Is In. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. Stay with us.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet colloidal silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality silver bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your silver bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assault.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I could see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. You are listening to an InfoWars.com frontline report. It's Alex Jones.
Well, the spread had the Packers winning by three, they won by five. And the reason we're going to focus some in on sports and entertainment more on this broadcast is to discredit it, is to expose it, and just to get people thinking, hey, you might want to spend more time with your kids, they don't turn out being heroin addicts, than just watching sports all day. It's designed and meant to distract men into basically these soap operas instead of having a life. You're supposed to have the type of complex thinking processes for business and life that you then put into football. So many men will bring up football to me or some other sport, and when I don't want to respond or I say I don't really follow that, they're shocked, like I'm not manly. No, I open carry semi-automatic rifles on the steps of the Alamo with the head of major state agencies when it's illegal. I do that for your rights in front of the cops, because their city law violates state law. I go and I get arrested in New York for the First Amendment. I go and make controversial films. I go into third world countries and war zones, and my crew does. So I know I'm not manly. I don't know all the football scores and all the stuff, but I started from nothing, a major media operation that reaches 18 million people a week one way or another. So it's like a badge of courage men have, that they watch Howie and everybody. And, when there's not ads with the Pittsburgh Steelers former quarterback up there promoting get your flu shot, get your single shots. I mean, it's just all a bunch of propaganda. And I know so much of it's rigged, and it's rigged through, what's the weakest link? Who's the easiest to buy? The referees. And joining us is Brian Toohey. The Fix Is In is the book I've read. He's got a new book out that I'm going to read soon. The Showbiz and Manipulation of the NFL, MLB, NBA, NFL, and NASCAR. And he got into the FBI files on this, folks. And the FBI's tried to investigate this. They're never really allowed to bring this up. They can bring up steroids and other stuff, or secret hit list, secret list to hurt people, like the Saints got caught, but not the fact that there's major fixing going on. I don't know his take on this yet. We called him. He could come on after the game. He joins us via video Skype. Brian, what's your breakdown on this? And then we'll walk into some of the confirmed fixes you know, not just Pete Rose and others, but some of the confirmed stuff that's going on out there.
Well, I think the main thing to remember, regardless of whatever game or whatever sport you're watching at the professional level, is the fact that it is not illegal for a league to fix its own games. There's no law that prevents this.
Says it on the ticket.
Yeah, well, that's part of your ticket. Your ticket promises you entry to see a game. If they present a game, it doesn't mean certain rules have to be followed. It doesn't mean certain players have to play. It doesn't mean a team cannot cheat. You paid to see a football game, for example. You saw a football game. They upheld their end of the bargain. So that's the main thing. If a league can do this, if they can fix their own games to manipulate them to make them more interesting so people stay and watch till the bitter end, or to even determine who wins and who loses, there's nothing the fan can do.
Have the power go out to make an extra $80 million?
That's part of the deal.
Oh, they wouldn't have the power out to make $80 million while everybody was watching.
Well, it's all about money. I mean, that's what the league puts the games on for. I mean, they put it on just for their own profit, for the television networks. And we've seen, I mean, statistically, it's shown that the television networks are surviving because of the National Football League. And then, of course, the advertisers are profiting from these leagues as well. So, I mean, there's a lot of entities involved in this. And I cannot believe a business like the NFL would leave itself up to pure chance. And that's what fans have to believe, that this is all a coincidence as how do these games play out. Who wins and who loses? It's just a lucky bounce of the ball. Well, no multi-billion dollar industry such as the NFL or any others would really allow their product up to chance if sure. they can control it.
And well, it's also tax exempt for people that don't know the league itself. So it has a partnership with the government.
Exactly. And then, like you said earlier, I mean, I think it makes a lot of sense that that occurs because if the government is using the NFL and the NBA and these other leagues, much like the Romans used the gladiator games to distract the populace from what the government is doing, then it's a perfect correlation to today's sport. And it does the same effect. I mean, you see it just from, like you say, the controversial call in today's game. How many people are up in arms paying attention to that, but yet they don't even know what's going on within their government and other entities?
It's a great distraction. Now you're an expert on the fixes that are there. And I read your book, but it was last year. It was a couple years ago. But from my research, obviously boxing matches are easy to rig if Don King owns both fighters, you know, things like that. But isn't it really, from your investigations, it's the refs that are the weak link, right?
Well, one of the weakest links for sure, because obviously they don't get paid the millions of dollars certain athletes like Peyton Manning and Tom Brady get paid. So it's harder to corrupt them. But that doesn't mean it's impossible that you cannot corrupt a player like that. I mean, we've seen with soccer where we've seen matches fixed all over the globe in soccer. I mean, it's the world's number one sport. It makes the most money. It's the most widely watched sport. And we've seen soccer matches at every level, all the way up to the World Cup, which is the biggest sporting event in the world. We've seen soccer matches be fixed. We know that's occurred. So why, if that's happened on the biggest stage possible, why do we think that a simple NFL game or NBA game could not be fixed? So as long as we know what's possible, then we have to figure out the roots as to how that can be done. And we know from the mafia, from its own history, that they find the weak link with people. They find the ways to corrupt people, be it through women, be it through drugs, be it through gambling, whatever. They find that weakness, they exploit it, and they make money off of it. If the mafia can do that, why can't the league do it when they control the players and referees all the same?
Well, I mean, look, a lot of the owners come from major gangster families to begin with, even on the Italian side. Sports is historically corrupt. I think, as you said, soccer's been caught a bunch. Other sports have been caught all over the world. I think the U.S., Japanese sports are famously fixed. Massive gamblers, huge gambling in China. I mean, gambling all over. But I've seen the numbers. It's 8 to 10 times more money just for the NFL. But in sports in general, it varies in gambling total than what the sports even make. So that shows that everything's geared towards the gambling, right?
In a way, yeah. Because, I mean, like you say, the NFL makes about $10 to $11 billion a season. Most of that money comes from the television networks that really fund the sport. But we know from studies, and I mean, they're just kind of estimates on how much sports gambling is done every year. The last good estimate comes from 1999, and that says anywhere from $80 to $380 billion every year.
And we all know it's much bigger now.
Well, yeah, I mean, around the world. I mean, if you go global, where many of these big-time gamblers will bet offshore, they'll bet in Europe, they'll bet in Asia and other places. Yeah, I mean, who knows how much money is being spread around, and much of it is done illegally, and much of it is in organized crimes control. So when the NFL and the NBA and these other leagues prevented New Jersey from legalizing sports gambling in that state, like is allowed in Nevada, basically the leagues were siding with organized crime because it's one of the organized crime's biggest moneymakers.
Well, I think the nail in the coffin is the anti-gun, anti-family, anti-free speech messages of the NFL. I mean, you tune into it, and it is just brainwashing. And their partnership with Homeland Security and with Obama, and Obama is in the intro to Monday Night Football. I mean, even if I was a libertarian and they had a libertarian president as part of the intro, that's what you have in fascist countries or in Venezuela.
Oh, yeah, I agree. I mean, it's a perfect use of propaganda. I mean, it's a perfect way to get a certain audience's attention is to affiliate yourself with the National Football League. I mean, it's the most watched. I think they have 24 of the most 25 watched programs in the United States this year, or in 2014, I should say.
Sure.
I mean, it is the most watched thing. The Super Bowl is the most watched event, televised event.
Sure, and if you add all the derivatives of replays and everything, it's the most watched soap opera for men, NFL. Stay there. We'll be right back with our guest. The Fix is in.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know the fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Waging war on corruption. It's Alex Jones.
We're going to take a few phone calls at the end of this segment and the next with our guest with your specific comments or questions about fixing sports. Sports is the dominant cultural system worldwide. Hitler used the Olympics to control much of the planet to sell himself as a great guy in 1936. It is being used as a weaponized system. I like golf, even though I don't play a lot of golf, because you at least can go do it for your life. You're on the green out there. It's something where it's about you and your friends. But when it gets into professional sports, watching Lance Armstrong or watching the NFL, it gets sick. And then the characters are always such sickening narcissists. I'm tired of it. And then it's all dirty and it's just men moping around in the jerseys they wear, and that's the only identity they've got. I run into so many listeners that are wearing football jerseys and love the show. So it's not bad. I'm not saying you're bad if you like it. I'm saying we're too obsessed with it and not the real world. I criticize video game people. Well, I went and played video games today with my kids in an arcade. But we don't do it 5 hours a day. That's all I'm saying, is that it's sick. Now, I want to give Brian the floor. Here's the number. 877-789-ALEX. The Sunday number is a different number than the weekday number. 877-789-2539. I mean, all these plays that are so obviously not right, all these calls, that could be billions being made there if the fix is in. And believe me, it's institutionalized, ladies and gentlemen. 877-789-ALEX. Am I saying these refs did that? No. But we know it's going on. 877-789-2539. Brian, you've got the floor. Break down some of the known cases of fraud, especially in soccer, and stuff that's been really suspicious to you that you've seen in the last year, and any more intel you've gotten from the FBI files.
Well, I think you're right. I mean, I think if you look around the world again, you have soccer that's incredibly corrupt. I mean, from FIFA, the organization, on down to the games themselves. You have corruption in tennis, professional tennis, which is the second most bet upon sport in the world. You have cricket leagues, which are incredibly corrupt. Rugby, which has had match fixing allegations. You've had it everywhere around the world except here in the United States. And that's where I find it very interesting and very questionable as to how it could go on everywhere but here, supposedly. And that's what caused me to write this book, Larceny Games, my newer book.
Let's talk about Larceny Games, yeah.
Yeah, I went to the FBI and I obtained through the Freedom of Information Act every file the FBI had related to game fixing. And it amounted to well over 400 files. And I broke them down in the course of the book. And what I learned is that the NFL, Major League Baseball, the NBA all had numerous allegations of fixed games. And this goes from the 60s on through the 1980s when the files kind of dissipate and fall apart. And the thing that worried me was the fact that the FBI realized, especially in the case of the NFL, the NFL was covering this stuff up, and they were doing it. They were able to do it through their security divisions, which a lot of fans have heard about, you know, in regards to the
which are made up of former FBI.
Exactly. Former FBI guys, former CIA, DEA, Secret Service, law enforcement officials. They basically, the ones that the NFL or these leagues would hire, would go to the current ones and basically tell them to back off. The league will handle it. It's a league matter. And the FBI would back off. And that's how they would allow themselves to cover these things up, and then the media would never get a whiff of it. So it was all done in-house. It was all controlled in-house, and nobody learned about all these scandals. And trust me, there were numerous ones that should have been discovered that never made the press.
Keep going.
Well, I mean, you even look at a game like today. I mean, like I said, people are probably up in arms over the Cowboys-Packers game, and they were up in arms last week about the Lions and Cowboys games. And the fact is, I mean, I've been watching the NFL since I was a little kid. I no longer know what a catch is. I don't know what a touchdown is. I don't know what a penalty is, because the NFL and other leagues as well have kind of micromanaged themselves. And they've done it in the very same way that the government kind of has. It's like, as soon as they see some little tiny problem, they decide they need legislation that covers that and basically overdoes it. And that's what the NFL has done, to the point where now, I think, like I say, fans don't know what a catch is or isn't. And that's what happens. That's what causes a lot of this controversy. And that's what also allows the NFL a lot of wiggle room in order to do what they may want to do manipulation wise, is because if you don't know what a catch is, because you don't understand the definitions, and the definitions are so convoluted,
they leave a big gray area.
It's a huge gray area. So one week they could say what looks like a catch isn't a catch because of X, Y, and Z. And then that same similar catch is ruled not a catch because of, you know, some other reason. I mean, they can do it any way they want to do it. And the fans have to accept it because they're, you know, judge, jury, and executioner.
Well, that's just like fractional reserve banking and money manipulation or high-frequency trading. They claim it's somewhat legal, but only select firms have it. It's siphoning billions off of other people's profits a day, and it plays with just very small numbers in a margin. But you put it together, it ends up changing the entire outcome of corporate mergers, pension fund stability, ratings of countries. I mean, you start manipulating in those small areas, it builds up.
Well, and that's all you have to do. Is, I mean, you could take one play, one seemingly insignificant play, or sometimes one extremely significant play, and rule it one way or the other, and you alter the outcome of that game. It doesn't mean you have to have everybody involved in some giant conspiracy and fix. If you can get to one referee, if you can get to one player, and you can make one little play go this way or that way, you can alter the outcome of games. And it could be done for gambling purposes, or it could be done on a league level to institute, you know, certain rules. It could be done to make sure certain teams win. It could be done to extend certain storylines so the NFL or the NBA make more money because more people are watching, because they're more interested in this team as opposed to that team, even though the team that lost may be the actual better team. The game that was manipulated to make sure LeBron makes it to the finals or Tom Brady makes it to the Super Bowl or what have you. That's what they're trying to sell, and that's what's going to make them more money.
Because, He's the author of The Fix Is In. The website's thefixisin.net. Find both his books there, Amazon.com, bookstores everywhere. Larceny Games is the new one that I want to read. In fact, I'm going to order one because I want to read about these FBI files, understand how they block the FBI. You know, so many times the FBI does investigate things and then they get blocked by higher ups. It is just incredible how it's like the FBI is two different organizations. The grassroots doing a really good job, and then higher ups just time and time again block everything they're doing.
Well, and that's what happened in these files. I mean, I found it just utterly shocking because, I mean, first of all, it's amazing how much of the stuff was still redacted 50 years later or 30 years later. But it's also just shocking to the fact that, I mean, this was an investigation into a fixed football game or numerous fixed football games, whichever file you wanted to look at. And yet, yeah, the FBI would be blocked by hires up. You know, the base level guys, the agents who were doing a good job, were doing, you know, a solid investigative work, they would get squashed. And even one file specifically says that, written by the agents, that says the NFL was whitewashing what they were doing to make sure the NFL looked good. That's the way that league operated in the 60s. That's the way the league operates today. I mean, now they just had, you know, the former director of the FBI said, oh, you know, Roger Goodell did not see the abuse tape of Ray Rice. You know, everything was good with the NFL. It's all free and clear. Well, you know, a lot of fans, they don't believe it. They don't buy it yet. They have the power to affect things. They have the power to stop watching. They have the power to affect the pocketbook of the NFL to make them change. But yet fans are almost too addicted to the sport to do that because they keep tuning in week after week and buying what the NFL is selling.
Well, look, when I grew up in Dallas with the Von Erichs and all the regional wrestling, that was right as Ventura and Hulk and all of them were coming, I would watch it as a joke. But then even my friends would get mad when I said, it's fake. You don't hit somebody over the chair and not put them in a coma or kill them. I mean, I knew that when I was 7 years old. They didn't. Their parents told them it was real. I guess they told them Santa Claus was real, too. But would you say, from seeing the files that go back over 50 years up until they basically locked them down, is professional sports getting more like WWE, professional wrestling, totally staged? Or is it becoming less? I mean, is the corruption getting worse? Is the fakeness getting worse? Or is it pretty much the same?
I think it's getting worse because I think of the television's influence of it all. I think that's, I mean, they wrote, there was a famous guy named Bernie Parrish, who was a former NFL player. He wrote a book in which he said when the networks bought into the NFL, it felt like the networks bought the NFL and controlled it and ran it for their own purposes.
Well, sure, that's like reality TV. I've been involved in a bunch of it, and it's fake. It's staged. I refuse. Well, I've been offered over 30 big shows, I mean, with contracts. I won't do it because it's fake. They want me to act like a clown and do a bunch of fake stuff. I mean, that, and they tell people on the TV, this is real. This really happened. We'll be right back, folks. Stay with us. We'll be coming back. Your calls.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com and to help others during Christmas by teaching them about the powerful benefits of silver. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining 3 essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
In this present crisis, government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem. From time to time, we've been tempted to believe that society has become too complex, to be managed by self-rule. But government by an elite group is superior to government for, by, and of the people.
The Alex Jones Show, because there is a war on for your mind.
Matt, Chris, Phil,
meet the real me.
Michael, Brandon, we're going to get to your calls. A lot of great questions I see here on the board. This final segment with our guest, Brian Toomey, who wrote The Fix Is In. I read this book. I haven't read his new book. We got callers calling in who loved his first book. We used to sell it in the store. We need to order some more and do that at InfoWarsStore.com. Speaking of that, we did a limited run of 5,000 calendars. Buckley had the idea in late December. They just came in last week. Already about a third of them have sold. They'll be gone very, very quickly. They're $9.95, including shipping. So $9.95, usually a calendar costs $10. These have pro-gun, patriotic, anti-New World Order themes. It's great to give friends and family to introduce them to InfoWars.com. It's a nice little calendar. And you're basically, you know, getting it half off because it's $9.95. It has free shipping. So that includes shipping. But here's the reason you would gain your money back getting it. Each month has a promo code. Here's December of next year, December 2015, or of this year. 15% off store-wide, everything. Whether it's water filters, Made in America, pro-gun shirts, nutraceuticals, 15% off store-wide has the promo code.
Okay.
Here is all regular priced exclusive Alex Jones films, 50% off using promo code. That's in November. 50% off the films. Unbelievable. Here is October. I'm going backwards. Free domestic shipping using the promo code on everything. 10% off store-wide using the promo in the month of September. I mean, I'm not going to go any further. This is a test. If we sell the 5,000 out very quickly, next year I'll print 50,000. This is a beta test. It's basically a coupon book for InfoWarsStore.com. $9.95, shipping included, and it's a coupon book. No games here. An incredible coupon book, and your purchase supports the broadcast. All right, let's run through calls in the 8 minutes we have left quick. We're going to go back to the calls here. Matt in Tennessee, you're on the air with the author of The Fix Is In, Brian Toomey. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, thanks for taking my call. My question for Brian is, given the money that goes back and forth in betting with college football, is there the similar type of influence in the football bowl subdivision?
You're talking about NCAA?
Yeah, the NCAA Division I football bowl subdivision. You know, there are two. You have the FBS and the FCS.
Sure. Let me get Brian's take on that. I mean, from my layman research, sometimes gamblers are obsessed with even high school stuff. I mean, isn't there gambling and fixing going on everywhere?
Oh, sure. I think the college game is much more fixed in terms of gambling than the pro game.
Because of less money.
They're paid. Yeah, the kids don't get paid. So it's very easy, I think, to find kids in basketball or the football programs who aren't NFL or NBA material and say, look, you want to make a couple grand, you shave a few points. I think it's very easy to do. But I even think on the higher level, the NCAA, I mean, you look at like the bowl selection committee for who's playing in the national championship on Monday. There's a lot of questions that could be raised there too, because again, it's a multi-billion dollar industry and it's really nice because they don't have to pay the employees like they do in the NFL or the NBA.
And I mean, famously, those committees that decide the bowl games are as crooked as a dog's back leg. Thank you, Matt. Chris in Indiana, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Alex, Mr. Toomey, hello.
Welcome, brother. Go ahead.
Hey, I'm a former small gambler. It's a guilty pleasure, and I'm not anymore. And people need to watch Raging Bull and Two for the Money. Those are really two good movies that
are
closing gambling. And I went on a hot streak about a year and a half ago, cashed out and bought an AK-47. Then I lost $200 last Super Bowl where Denver was heavily favored and they got their butts handed to them by the Seahawks. Now, this play with this Green Bay-Dallas game, I was watching at the gym. I don't really watch this stuff much because it's a waste of my time, like you said, Alex. But I think he caught the ball. There was not enough evidence to reverse the call because the call on the field was that he caught it. But then there was enough evidence. You're supposed to have enough evidence to reverse the call, which there was not of, I think. Now, Green Bay was favored by 5.5 or 6, and they won by 5. So people.
Well, it depends on the spread, but yeah.
No, but the money line. check this out. The money line was Green Bay negative 250, which means if you bet $100, you only win like $25. And then Dallas was at plus 200. So if you bet 100, you get 100 plus 200. So look at the people that if Dallas won that game, that you look at that as a former gambler. You look at that money line and your mouth kind of waters like, oh, I'm going to bet on Dallas. But that's just suspicious. I mean,
yeah, it's a way to sucker everybody. Absolutely. Let me get Brian's take on that, Brian.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there are a lot of times when you see lines on football games, on basketball games that make absolutely no sense. And they're the ones that always seem to go the way the sports books or the casinos want them to go.
Yeah, you can see the ones when the fix is in. I'm not even a gambler, but I've read a lot about it. I mean, you can see when stuff's getting rigged.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. There are a lot of times there's these suspicious line movements, suspicious money that shows up. And supposedly, you know, like Las Vegas is on the lookout for these sort of things, but then you see it when 99% of it is done illegally. Who's watching that money and who's looking out for the little guy? The fact is, no one is.
Well, sure, Vegas is only looking out that they don't get burned, but you know they're making their own inside bets.
Oh, they have to be. I mean, the mob, the organized crime, created what they call the layoff system back in the 60s. So all these little bookies could feed each other and bet upon each other so nobody had too much liability and risk on any game. So, I mean, it's a national syndicate that runs this
stuff. Sure, it's like insurance. They all pool their risk. Phil in Florida, you're on the air. Thanks for calling. Go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead, brother.
Okay, Mr. Tui, I read your first book. It was great, and it actually inspired me to start writing a novel of my own.
Awesome.
With the one thing that you missed in the first book, but you're picking it up now in the second book with the TMZ aspect. And the only other thing I wanted to say is that just for people in New York City, even though I'm calling from Florida, the MTA just hired a guy named David Mayer, and Alex, you'll know that name from the TWA Flight 800 cover-up. The witnesses didn't see what they saw. So I would be careful if I was in New York City and on mass transit.
All right. Yeah, that's a whole other place the fix is in. People getting big insurance policies. What about the issue that he was just raising about the TMZ factor you're right about?
Well, I mean, it's just interesting the fact that, you know, ESPN, Sports Illustrated, all these big major media, sports media outlets couldn't do what TMZ did, which is, you know, make a phone call to get this, you know, allegedly impossible to find tape on Ray Rice and the elevator incident and all that. I mean, I just find it amazing that the sports media exists in many ways to protect the leagues that they fund.
It's disgusting. It's really disgusting.
Yeah, they feed upon each other. I mean, it's a self-regulating industry because the NFL will tell, you know, I mean, we just saw it actually. He was on Deadspin the other day where the NFL basically made Al Michaels last night read a statement about the Ray Rice investigation.
Well, sure, let's expand on that. Like the White House press corps where they have to take selected questions now.
Exactly. It's the very same thing. It's not a freewheeling, you know, media investigation into these leagues. It's the leagues telling the media what it should do, and then the media responding. I mean, it's
and this is just one window into it, real fast. Brandon in Utah. Brandon, what's your quick question, brother?
Hi, how are you doing, Alex and Brian?
Good. Go ahead.
I agree with your analysis on the game today. I don't really watch. I haven't watched the game the whole season.
He caught the ball before he hit the ground.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't need to be a sports analyst to see that.
Yeah, I'm calling in just to ask. I know the elite, by whatever means, use the people and take advantage of us. But overall, if I'm talking to somebody and I bring this up, how would I explain to them? Because I explain to them it's just an illusion, like the freedom is just an illusion. But when I bring in the NFL, I just want the overall picture of what, because I haven't read any of your books, Brian.
Yeah. Well, I think if you go to my website, which is thefixisin.net, I have a little page that's called The Proof. And I would send people to that because it lists five facts, undeniable facts about the sports leagues and how they can legally manipulate their own games. And I mean, if people read that and still want to say I'm crazy, or if they want to believe that the NFL is as pure as, you know, new snow, go ahead. But I think if you really realize the nature, then you have to, you know, change the way you're thinking and look at these sports.
People just need to stop being so naive. Sports fixing is admitted all over the world, but here they've been better at covering it up.
And that's why they went after Pete Rose so much, was because he got caught. He wasn't in trouble for manipulating stuff and gambling. He was in trouble because he got caught.
Yeah, that's basically it. How is it that no other professional athlete is gambling on sports since Pete Rose? No one's been busted of gambling on sports. I find that absurd. Because they've been busted.
Brian, great job. The fix is in more than sports, and we're just here getting people to think for themselves. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thanks for having me, Alex. I appreciate it.
You bet. Great job to the crew. Sorry to all the other callers. I'll be back tomorrow live, 11 a.m. Central, with a weekday transmission, InfoWars.com.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I could see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.